there is someone who isn't from the right, who has a little bit of a different perspective than Brett Ehrlich and myself, which is Mr. Cenk Uygur. I think you guys all know him. He says, Neera Tanden has been waiting for this appointment for 4 unending years now. All of her hard work inside the establishment paid off. Now she's in a power position to help direct the world's largest resources. Now we're going to find out who she is, and so is she rooting for her.
This trended last night. Everyone thought this was an earnest tweet from Cenk being like, let's see how Neera Tanden shakes out. And I read that and I was like, yeah, real rooting for her to see who she is when you already know. It's so weird. Yesterday, Cenk was tweeting for two different tweets that people absolutely misinterpreted. It was hilarious. Yesterday, he was like, oh, he was talking to like MAGA chuds who were saying that Hillary Clinton rigged the 2020 election for Biden. And he was like, so she rigged it for Biden, but not herself? Is that your argument? Like, why would she rig an election she wasn't involved in, you dumb, dumb idiots? And everyone's like, well, why are you not defending Bernie? It's like, he did that in the beginning of that tweet, you dipsh.
No, and then so this funny. And this tweet this. Is like, yes, reading it at face value, it drips with sarcasm, all the unending work inside the establishment. And he's absolutely right. You know, she has been working toward this moment. I think the questionable part was like rooting for her.
Good luck. Rooting that she figures out. No, this is sarcastic in my reading.
I think it is sarcastic now that I read it again, but I absolutely, you know, he's obviously not wrong. And now, yeah, we do know who she is. She's going to probably require a whole lot of pushing. And again, I'm not someone who says it's done. Oh, we've pushed the Biden administration. They're done. They're unpushable. No, I think that's BS. I think it makes sense. Sadly, it makes sense that someone like Neera Tanden was elected. I actually just think on a pure HR level, on a pure liability level, the fact that you tweet that much, it's like, how many times have you put your foot in your mouth? How many times are you going to put your foot in your mouth? I don't believe in like digging up tweets and canceling people, but this is clearly someone who is so attracted to drama and loves to jump into it that like, don't you think you need someone maybe a little bit more even keeled at the helm of the Office of Management and Budget, you know, rather than someone who will just get baited into any kind of argument?
Yeah. And there's a whole stupid politics aspect to it. It's just stupid politics. Here's what frequently I think happens is, and I think Cenk pointed this out in a different tweet, but essentially there are people who are like, I am going to fight outright every step of the way for progressive goals, and you need them and I respect it. And that's one way to do it. And that might be the most respectable thing to do. There's other folks who are like, I've got to be strategic and I got to work my way up through the establishment to make the changes I want to see in the world. And people do that. And sometimes, you know, there are folks that make the beeline and find the right or at least the right angle to get in and affect change. AOC is one of them. I want to get in, you know, she's not one of those folks who are like, let's just screw it all and do it all from the outside. She's like, I want to run for Congress. I want to affect change. Neera Tanden, incidentally, I believe thinks she is AOC when she tweets. Like she thinks she totally nails it and she can't. She doesn't have the skill and it's fine. Not everybody, I don't have the skill. A lot of people don't have the skill. So there's that. But what ends this, the stupid politics aspect is people who believe they're going in and working their way through the establishment are gonna get called out by people who are on the outside being like, don't cave for a second, don't compromise, don't do anything.
Right.
If they really believe in the progressive goal, they can't let the calling out of themselves from people in the like purest aspect of the party to get them pissy, for lack of a better word. Like so frequently, like here's what happens. People make their way through. They're like, I was fighting for progressive change, but y'all are making this so frustrating for me that when I finally get to the position of power, I'm tempted to say, screw it. I like this job. I get to be the OMB director. And this is the giving the benefit of the benefit of the benefit of the doubt to Neera Tanden. Like, in the best possible interpretation of everything she's done, something that she's given us a lot of evidence not to believe, but let's say we believed it for a second already, you've pissed off all the purists by doing that, qualifying it that much. But Now what I think Neera Tanden would do if she was that golden secret progressive that everybody wanted her to be. I think she's just a little like, you guys are annoying. So I'm not going to do it because you made me not. Because you were
Bernie bros made me not give you healthcare. That is mean Bernie bros on Twitter are the reason we can't have a Green New Deal. So again, I think she is definitely sort of a yes woman of the status quo. Yeah, I hope she's not. I hope she fancies herself an AOC. I also don't really know how much the OMB does. I guess I've been, I guess it's important.
Well, let's just say
that the OMB doesn't operate on their own.
Mick Mulvaney did it while being chief of staff.
Right. Like the current director of the OMB is someone I've never heard. It's something like Richard Kraust or Cruz or Krusley. And the fact that I've never heard that name for me is like a plus because it means less evil. Like we've all heard of Stephen Miller. You know, we all heard of Scott Perdue when he was in. We all heard of, you know, Ryan Zinke. Like all these crooks have come and gone. We've heard of these people, but I never heard of this guy. So I'm like, hey, maybe that means it doesn't have that much power. Yeah. If it's not Chad Wolf, then maybe it's okay.
I think it's a think tanky thing. They're the ones that OMB looks at it and says, how much will this actually cost us? That's what I've seen the OMB. Like, the real effect from the, you know, independent OMB is that it'll cost $70 trillion over 700 years. Like that's what they do. So we'll see. And a think tanky person in charge of that, they probably thought made sense and they needed to give her something because she was in the establishment wing working for people. And I know there's people in the Twitch chat who are earlier saying like Andrew Yang will get something. And that's interesting. But Andrew Yang, I think, was just the person who was a viable presidential candidate who will go on TV. I think he's working to be that guy who fights for, you know, at least his version of what he thinks is progressive change from the inside. And we'll see how that pans out.
Andrew Yang just wants $1,000 a month for himself and whoever is going to pay that is fine. You know, he just wants to make sure he's got the cushy job forever. At least it's only $1,000. In fact, I don't think Andrew Yang should make more than $1,000 a month. That's just my personal view. I would like to see where the universal basic income discussion goes, especially with a recession, especially with the lack of action from Republicans. Is it the one thing that the left and the right can agree on? Will we get that before we get any kind of other relief? I don't
Francesca, like 80% of people want more gun control. 65% of people want Medicare for all. There are so many things that most Americans agree on that don't become law. And I guarantee you for what my word is worth, or my predictions are worth, I guarantee you this will all disappear when we start giving vaccines out. Period.
Yeah, maybe. I hope my vaccine comes with a King Kong poster. I want that. Don't slight me, Matthew Broderick.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.